spot because this could go on. Yes.
But the Meon, of course, is the opposite of being. It's a Greek word, Meon. But it's interesting that if you look at a very good biblical dictionary and encyclopedia, it's also a name of an ancient Canaanite city in Palestine, which was inhabited by worshippers of the goddess Ishtar in one of her manifestations. And it's very important for us to see not only the category of non-being as otherness, but in many ways as a threatening breakthrough into our own consciousness from our own id or unconscious levels of mind. The Meon, therefore, is otherness, and can be, could, or I should say, frequently is something different when you have two or more things combined. Then they say, this is X and this is Y. Or they'll say, this is being and this is nothingness. The major problem is, how do we use the word? And quite frequently in ordinary work, like in the Voodoo Gnostic workbook, we introduce the concept in order to help people sharpen their concepts about magical principles in order to keep, shall we say, negative force fields from attacking them from their own unconscious while they study, thinking they're such good students and such, shall we say, fortunate people to possess the secrets of the universe, when in reality, this is, as Lovecraft would say, a technique of deception, whereby the mind becomes open to invasion. So, in many ways, Meon can be a good thing. When you say, I want apples or oranges, well, the apples, that's my choice of being on my table, and the oranges will be the Meon or later, or it can be something that awakens a person's experience of total absence of reality as they've ever experienced it. And that becomes the Meonic world that H.P. Lovecraft celebrated. He didn't write about it. He celebrated it in the liturgies of all his books and short stories. And if you're interested in the H.P. Lovecraft tradition, hang out here in the bookstore. Because, of course, Kenneth Grant was one of the leading exponents of the revival of interest in H.P. Lovecraft, the great American Gnostic. Thank you for coming this evening.